Hi everyone, this is Nico71 and you're watching a design secret of the Ford F150 with the complete story and design process on this creation. Let's go! This creation is an alternate model of the LEGO Technic 42-115 Lamborghini Sian. As a lowered modified version of a Ford F150. It features 4x4 drivetrain with 8-speed sequential gearbox, fake V8 engine, aux steering with working steering wheel, adjustable suspension height, opening doors, hood and tailgate. Let's go for the model presentation. I had the Lamborghini Sian for a while now. I wanted to make an alternate model when I saw the potential of the set. But I was struggling on other projects. Then, when I wanted to start, there were many other alternative models available for this set, mainly made by James Tilson. So, I have to find an interesting idea. I came up first with a SUV idea, a Lamborghini Urus. But the shape was too difficult to make with only the part of the set, especially the rear mirror guard with opening door. Then, I started to work on an Aston Martin DBS, which fits the available parts for the light, but the green parts was too restrictive to have the correct shape for the side. I continued to search and find this pickup truck, a lowered and modified version of a 2019 Ford F-115 made by Vossen Wheel, which fits very well the look of the Sian wheel. It enabled me to make something different than a supercar with hidden key features. This is my first 1-to-8 supercar, but well, indeed, it's not a supercar but more a super pickup. The model is equipped with a DNA 8-speed sequential gearbox with end stop from modified version of the project Pimp My Sian. It enables to have a low profile gearbox to place the rear seat above compared to the Sian one. The end stop avoids to go from the 8th gear to the 1st and the 1st to the 8th. The modifications are reducing the gearing friction by changing axle length and bracing and the placement of the knob lever connection between the two gearbox, which is inside the gearbox and not outside. The stepper mechanism is a modified version from LEGO Technic Mastery Micro Stepper, which enables to fit it between the two seats, instant behind the steering wheel, which I find more easier to reach. The red lever is a drive neutral reverse and the yellow is the speed selector. The steering is operated by a classic rack and pinion, which is operated by a hand of God, but also has a return on the steering wheel. Unfortunately, as the front is heavy and the tire generate a lot of friction, it is hard to make turning the wheel with the steering wheel. Therefore, it has to be operated by a hand of God, preferably in movement. I find anyway that the steering wheel is hard to reach to plain supercar like in the Sian, that is why I prefer the Hog. Regarding the suspension, the front suspension are double wishbone and the rear is a live axle. The key feature of this model is the adjustable riding height. As the original inspiration model is low as possible for styling, I wanted to create these features to use the travel of the suspension. Therefore, the upper fixation of the chock absorbers are mounted on the rotating lever with two cusp positions. Each position has different end stops, which create the two different heights. The position can be adjusted by removing the half pin or adding a 1x1 round plate or other part to control the riding height. To finish with the openable element, the hood can be opened, revealing the fake V8 engine, but also the 4-door and the tailgate. You can note that the tailgate is attached to the frame with two small levers. It is to enable the opening without colliding the bumper because of the round shape of the rear panel. That is why the tailgate can be locked by the two grey side levers. let's talk about the design process. The design was of course an important point on this creation, combining with the part restriction of the set, that is why I started the project by the bodywork. I create first a road chassis for propulsion, then created the side and the front as they use the majority of the flat panel and the green parts, but also because the particular shape of the front was indeed the most important to have the truck recognizable. Then, I was able to see which green parts were left and design the other elements accordingly, like the rear trunk. After that, I create the front and rear axle with adjustable height suspension and start working on the gearbox. At the first time, I wanted to use the gearbox from the Lamborghini Sian, but it was too big in height and they were not end stop to avoid gear changing from 1st to the 8th. That is why I have used the gearbox of the project Pim Machian, which I modified to put the knob lever in it and reduce the friction. Then I create a chassis to connect all the elements and start reworking the bodywork attachment. When finished, I work on the interior and the dashboard and the final detail to have a neat look. Of course, this creation has soft default, mainly due to the part limitation and its size. First is the steering. As told before, it is preferable to operate the steering through the hog instead through the steering wheel because it is harder. If I would have more gearing, I would be able to gearing down the steering wheel to have a more functional steering wheel. Second drawback is that the lever which hold the suspension are now locked in place, which means if you leave the model, the wheel fall in their lower position. It doesn't affect the suspension height, but it would have been better to have an automatic locking device, which I was not able to make because of the part limitation. The last default is about the side design. As I ran out green panels and beam, I have to choose between green side or green hood. I preferred the green hood, so I put the leftover black panel on the lowest part on the side. It gives a nice black trim design, which is in the continuity of the black bumper, but I think it would have been better with green instead. Let's conclude on this creation. Creating an alternate model is always a compromise between part restriction, neat design and uncommon features. The idea is not to propose the same thing as the original set with some modifications, but something different which enhances the possibilities of this set without removing the value proposition for the original set. And for this one, despite some default, I think it's rather successful, with a clean and powerful look and interesting features. Thank you for your attention. If you want to see the original video, please click on the recommended left video. I also put another interesting video if you are new on my channel. Please consider subscribing if you like my content. Take care, play well, bye.